Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Pokemon Ultra Sun Blind Nuzlocke. We are currently on Pony Island, and we got past the first couple areas of the Pony Island. Now we're going into the Ruins of Hope, where Hapu's going to be given kahuna powers and basically become a slave to Tapu Fini. Kind of like how Olivia's a slave to Tapu Lele. So, yeah. Ruins of Hope. What is it? The air feels so oppressive. Yeah, that line's still there. The air is oppressing her. It's a mystic water. That sounds promising. Sarcastically, is what I said. Who saves you? I'll be the one who saves you. Yeah, good one, Lily. That's a real good one. Oh. Machamp? We gotta use Machamp. That's right. I forgot that we got him last episode. We need to push these huge blocks. Lily, don't even try it. Really? Gee, I wonder what we have to do. I cannot even express how difficult this is. Like, you don't even know. You don't even know. Alright, well, here's what we're going to do. We're going to press Y. Machamp, you are going to be set to down. Because we don't need to use Mudsdale ever again. So, I mean, we probably actually do. Just because they need an excuse to make an obstacle for Mudsdale. Just to try to justify it being a thing you can ride on. But, you know, I appreciate being able to ride on a Mudsdale. It's just, you know, it doesn't really help except for the... You know, I've been through this. Sorry. All right. Run as Machamp, and I still think how you ride a Machamp is dumb, because it's only using two of its arms to push things instead of all four, which makes so much more sense. Using two of its arms to carry you, which is not that difficult to do. He could probably lift you with one finger based on how strong he is. So, you can easily ride on his shoulders. All right, here we are. Here's Hop, who's going to get Tapu Fini, kahuna power things, and we're going to die to her. That'll be fun. Ride with me, you know. Although the secret ruins, the guardian deities worship within them. They go wherever they want. It's not easy to meet them, according to the books I've read. You mean you mean Tapu Koko, who we met? That because he saved, like, at the very beginning of the game, because he saved us? Because we had that cutscene again? Of us blowing up the bridge? Or Nebby blowing up the bridge? Yeah, good times. Good times. That was when I still had optimism for the game. I'm sorry. Here's a Z-Rock thing. So Hapu can use Z-moves now. That's really unfortunate. I give my thanks for a great blessing. As Kahuna, I will do my best for the people. And the Pokemon of Alola, even though I'm only like 8. Like, seriously, she must be, like, like 8. She's shorter than me, and I'm 11. Oh, you two are watching. Well, we're just kind of following you, because that's the only way to go right now. Yeah, I must be really something. I was chosen as Kahuna, and now I'm a Kahuna, because, that's how this works. Lily, Kahuna USB is right here. Oh yeah, good up! Well, tell him about the legendary Pokemon! Tell us now! The Solgaleo, the Altar of the Sun. We must go after my mother. And she wants us to do something about the Crozma. So we need Solgaleo to go get the Crozma. That actually makes complete sense. And when we get there, Necrozma will fuse with Solgaleo, becoming the thing on the box art. And that'll be the thing we fight. Although, I do understand that there's an Ultra Necrozma form that I've actually seen a picture of it, so I know what it looks like. So I don't actually know how that form plays in. But yeah. It's probably the form we fight that everyone thinks is ridiculously hard. I just don't know why then there would be the thing on the box art that's, you know, the fusion of Solgaleo and Necrozma. Touch the statue. There's no reaction from the statue. But nobody came. All right, let's leave. Let us leave. I'll meet you when something important happens. I forgot where I go. Do I go up? I think I go up. There's a guy here. Is he a trainer? You wanna go to the best way? You need permission from the Kahuna. There is no Kahuna. How do you know there's a Kahuna? Okay, I don't know where I'm going. Sorry. Here's something important happening, I think. Hello. Thank you, Happy. Thank you, Mudsdale. For what? Friends. Oh, wait, we do Exaggerator Island first. That's right. Yeah, we gotta do the Exaggerator Island. I forgot about that part. Yeah, we do that first, then we're gonna fight Hapu. And I will not be catching Alolan Exeggutor. I don't care if that's the only thing on that area. I will not catch it because it was part of my final team in the first Sun. It was Pickle, who was surprisingly very good. Like, very, very good, actually. But, you know, I don't want to use repeat things, especially from the Sun Nuzlocke. Are we talking to Mina now? Actually, I'm very confused. How was the Maid the New Kahuna? Yeah. And... And if you're gonna be as well, it's a place we need to go. To Exeggutor Island, yes. Here, get the chief. Did you call me? Okay. Oh my goodness. Nice to meet you. I'm the chief of the sea folk. Couldn't have overhearing. You want to get this Exeggutor Island? Oh, thank you. Pretty crazy place. Yeah, there's Exeggutor. I got this. You and Absol can do it. So wait, is Elaine not coming with us? I thought that was like part of her big deal. She was coming with us on this island. Oh, we're going to the Magikarp boat. She's staying back? But I thought she has like character development on Exeggutor Island or something. You know, like when it starts raining and stuff? Remember that part? Like, cause yeah, raining, see? Remember that part? Character development, guys? There was a sticker under that rock. And there's the Flute of the Sun, just, you know, sitting there unguarded, out in the open. It's a piece of wood. It's obviously, it's probably really rotted wood by now, with bugs living in it and stuff. I will probably play a sound anymore. And now it's not even subtle about there being little Exeggutors everywhere. Before they were actual palm trees, and, like, one attacked you as you walked closer to it. Now they're literally just Exeggutors running around. It used to be trial site, huh? There are noise bunches, but it's probably fine. You're on, good luck. Thanks. Thanks a lot. And are they just gonna attack us? Good, it's exactly a bit odd. Thwack! Yeah, okay, we can just talk to an Exeggutor and fight it if we want, but... What?! Exeggutor's acting weird! Because it's actually a pincer! Alright, I will gladly get a pincer, thank you very much. I will gladly get a pincer. We're gonna throw a quick ball right away on that. Yeah, pincer. That made absolutely no sense, but I don't care. Was it like hiding in its branches or something? That's what I'm gonna guess. Like the pincer was like shaking its branches and pincer fell out or something? That makes as much sense as I can think of, so. We got pincer, good. Pinsir wouldn't be a bad Pokemon. It's not an amazing Pokemon. It's pure bug, and it... I mean, I could probably learn Leech Life or X-Scissor with my TM, so... It wouldn't be a bad option, but it's probably not one I'm gonna rush to use. So, alright, name for this. This is Conda. Why? Because it's the name of a sword. Conda's summary. You have Quiet. Plus Special Attack. Oh, it does have X-Scissor by level up. Okay. That must have been in a recent generation, because I definitely didn't learn any bug moves at some point. Alright, send to a box. Bye, Conda. Maybe I'll use you someday. The user is now waving its head around. Happily, the pincer was chased off. Oh! The pincer was, like, clamping it! So... Do I have to save all the Exeggutors or something? Because, you know, why not? Grrrr! Are there just pincers in all of their branches and they're like causing troubles or something? I'll see what happens if I save all the Exeggutor. Maybe that's what I'm supposed to do, because that actually makes a lot more sense to, you know, have to actually do something on this island as opposed to just coming here, getting the flute and leaving. So I'm okay with them having put something here as, you know, a thing to actually do. So yeah, let's go to Falchion for this. I still want Saber up front though, because Saber needs to be up front more often. Submission! Yeah, that didn't do anything. Acrobatics! Yay! Goodbye, pincer. You probably had a better nature than Quiet, but... Oh, well. And yeah, that pincer, I mean, that Xator's not happy. Is now the other one gonna be like a Vikavolt? Let's have Machete up front. Because why not? And I don't even know, I don't even really care what would have been in the grass, because I'm totally okay with getting pincer. And I don't want to be disappointed by seeing something that I would have liked better. No, they're all pincers. Okay. They're all pincers. So in theory, pincer was a guaranteed encounter. So I could have ignored it if I wanted to, because it guaranteed encounter, but I didn't really know that. And I also don't really care. Storm Throw doesn't affect me. Take this, Anchor Shot. Yeah. It's more like Anchor Bind than it is Anchor Shot. It's not like whacking them with an anchor. It's wrapping them in a chain that just happens to have an anchor on the end, you know? But whatever. It's a good move, so I don't really care of the specifics. Yay, 51. That was good. Now that we saved all the Exeggutor, do we get something? Yes, we do. Apparently, that's what we had to do, apparently. I had a feeling. And what are they doing? What are they doing? Where did the Exeggutor wander off to? Is he gonna let me climb on it now? Is that it? Wait, what's in this little cave here? Oh, that's where me and Lily used to hide. That's where me and Lily would hide in the rain when Lily came with me in the last dimension we played through this. Oh, wait, whoops. that cave is still there because they didn't feel like taking it out. Shamsher, you be up front with Sabina close behind. Sabina's also someone I feel like isn't up front very often. That's all right. Yep, it lifted you up. Yep, they didn't care to make an animation for it. Crash, crash, and crash. There's a sticker here. 69 stickers. Aw, yeah. I probably could have had like over 100 by now if I had been looking close enough. But oh well. I can't really get any more rewards from the stickers. Anyway, because I've already gotten my one Pokemon that I could get for encounter-wise, and yeah, it died like right away. So, the flu is this very odd pedal. No. I don't feel like it. Fine, I'll take it. Yes, I'll take the flute. You obtained the Sun Flute! Yay, the Sun Flute! Yes! Sun Flute of Flutiness. Now we can play a flute salad. With our moon and sun flute. And wow, it's like an orange rainbow because I'm playing during dusk. That's really weird. I wonder what it would look like at any other time of the day. Probably daytime would be a regular rainbow. What would it be at nighttime? It'll be a rainbow at nighttime? Because that's like not possible, I'm pretty sure. Was there really something Pokemon like you like me that much? No, I just solved their problems for them. That's why. It's not weird. Alright, I'm gonna go heal, then I'm assuming I have to walk to that area I was at before and find Hapu and fight her and then die to her. So I'll see you there. Oh! This part. Crap. I forgot about this part. I don't wanna do this part. Whatever. On the bright side, this is the very, very last time we have to fight Team Skull. Then we'll be done with them forever. At least until post-game, probably. Here they come! How about you numbskulls in Ether? Do you really know how to open Ultra Wormhole and save our boy Guzma? Let me see if you really are bad to the bone enough to save our boy Guzma. Let's work together. By work together, I mean let me fight you to make sure we can work together. Whatever. Oh, and then I believe we fight Plumeria again after them. And yeah, I don't want to fight Plumeria either, because of all the freaking people in this game to sweet me, who in the world saw Plumeria coming? I guarantee you nobody did, except maybe during that battle, and you realized, oh crap, he is nothing for Salazar. Maybe then, but before that, I guarantee no one predicted that. So I guess Thunderbolt this Ekans. Oh my god, you're faster than, and you know, they still can't even bother to give Team Skull evolved Pokemon. That's honestly a little sad. Like, they're not even trying to make them hard. I understand that, like, in almost all Pokemon games, if not all of them, evil team grunts always have very weak Pokemon, and I don't understand why that needs to be a recurring theme. Like, why? This is late game. There's no excuse for them not to have their evolved Pokemon. Heck, I think Team Rocket, at the very least, had evolved Pokemon. Yeah, they were like Raticate, Golbat, Weezing, Muk, things like that. But they were still evolved forms of those Pokemon. Yeah, Foman is not Lurantis, because they're too good for that. They're too good for Lurantis, so Fomantis. And I gotta say, guys, I don't care how much this jinx is, but I have to say it. Shamshir, I'm so freaking happy I have someone still around from the beginning of this playthrough. If Shamshir dies, I will no longer recognize my team. As, like I like the rest of my team. Don't get me wrong. They're very good members, and I'll be very sad to see any of them die. But, like, Shamshir, maybe Felchin as well. Yeah, Shamshir and Felchin are the only real ones I feel like have been around a good... Shamshir, very beginning. Literally very beginning. Felchin's been around a while. Same with Sabina, I guess, but I don't know. I feel like Sabina hasn't done as much. That's why I don't feel much as a connection to Sabina, but... Shamshir, a lot. Felchin, a good amount. And yeah, Sabina, a little bit. The other three, they're fairly new. I like them a lot, of course. You know what? I bet you can kill him with Bulldoze. I don't even want to risk using the Stone Edge and having it possibly miss. We're just going to use Bulldoze because, yeah, can't be bothered. See, I was right. It's a freaking Houndour, not a Houndoom. Golbat, not a Crobat. At least it's not Zubat, right? Thunder Punch, not Stone Edge because... And they're not even trying! They're not even trying, guys. They're not even trying. And you can tell it's starting to turn nighttime in the background. I really like that. It's a shame that the other hours of the day can't have this much variance. But no, it's Raticate. Oh, that's special. It's reserved only for dusk. For the different times of that day to... Oh my god, another enemy Raticate's missed. Fine, guys. Now they've missed twice. The Raticates we fought, they've now missed twice. Are you happy now? Because, like, that would have totally mattered, right? If Sucker Punch hit my physically defensive golem. Yeah. Totally would have... Oh, Thunder Punch would have done more damage. Oops. Oh, well. It didn't matter, clearly. Let's lose Bulldoze again, just to prove a point. All right, Plumeria, get over here! I'm ready for ya! Shamshir's ready for ya! Specifically Shamshir. The rest of us are still okay, but Shamshir specifically. And they're all dead. I may have lost. Listen up, yo. Please save Goose before us. You dummies. Trying to save the boss. So why do you get under getting in their way for? Yeah. Don't use logic, for crying out loud. Or are we not going to fight Plumeria? And we're just going to talk to her? I don't remember. You girly. Lily, right? You really ready to do this finally? Because I've treated you really badly. If anyone was doing the work the president told me to, I shouldn't have done all that. If I apologize now, it's probably too late for me to forgive me, though.
Plumeria, I will never forgive you.
He really likes the president. He's dulled whoever, you know, strong he was. Other people, I don't care what they might want. Do you want to help each other? Well, isn't that what Lucifine's doing to try to stop Necrozma? She's technically helping each other out by trying to defeat Necrozma. Unless I missed it, they never once said Lucifine wants to capture Necrozma. They said she wants to stop him. Poison of Z Crystal, maybe it'll help you somehow. Nope! Nope! It won't! Thanks anyway, though! So no, I guess we don't fight Plumeria. That's fine. I'm totally alright with that. You'll be fine, though. I'm out. Thank you, Plumeria. I appreciate you not killing us again. Are you gonna heal us? Thanks, Lily. That saves me a trip to go fly back. Vast Pony Canyon lies ahead. Basically, the Victory Road. But not Victory Road. Because it's not. It's more of a Victory Road than the actual Victory Road is. And now it's officially nighttime. Or is it? It's 5:50 the time I'm playing. And so I guess it stops being dusk around now. See, that is really interesting. That the effects of the day change constantly during this single hour. Okay, here's where we die to Habu. Hold on, let me make sure we're all good here. Alright, I've decided we're starting with Machete for grass. Energy ball. Okay? Makes sense, right? Let's do it. Habu, bring it on. I didn't get swept to The water totem, I lost 4 Pokemon. I didn't get swept to Lucemane, I lost 1! And I'm not getting swept to you! I got swept to Plumeria. One sweep is enough for me. Yes, nothing wrong with that, Lily. If you look and save the things and the stuff, that's my grandpa used to say before he died. Please. Oh, I didn't expect that. We've been betrayed by Lucemane. No! And we were expected to put our faith in a child like you next? Even though we are still weak, we have also learned to battle with Pokemon. We should be the ones to resolve the situation with the crowd, but ourselves! I will defeat you! We will handle things with our own power this time! Okay, I was not expecting that. Crap, I started with the wrong Pokemon. Dang it! Okay, so this seems like the final battle with these guys. It's still just gonna be him with Poipole, though, isn't it? Yeah, Poipole. Really, guys? Well, poison is not super effective against Machete, because Ghost resists poison, so it's gonna be regular effective. So we should be okay. Let's try an Anchor Shot.
Quick Claw, X Defense, screw you very hard.
Fine, I guess we use special attacks on you. Can no longer escape, yeah, because you'll totally switch out right now, right? Let's go to Shamshare, my only special attacker, and we'll T-Bolt it. T-Bolt, heh. Toxic, oh, I don't like that. I don't like that one bit. I really, really don't like that, actually. I hope I get healed before the Hapu battle. That's all I care about. I hope I get healed before the Hapu battle. Nasty plot? We have to kill this thing right now. Like, kill it right now. Right now! No! You didn't kill it. What if he heals? If he heals, my switching out will not help us. I'm gonna go for a Thunderbolt. He did heal. I'm glad I did not switch out. Now die. Boop. Goodbye. Do I understand my Pokemon a little better now? Maybe you should catch more. You're not limited. You had a fervor before. What happened to that? Can we not stand up to the long history of a region like Alola, where the culture of Pokemon has had so long to develop? No, you just suck. Pokemon of Alola get along and get to know each other through Pokemon battles. Greetings, I'm the Kahuna of this island, just, you know, 5 minutes ago. You're from the Beast World. We live together with Pokemon. If you're in some sort of trouble, we can help. You know, in all seriousness, though, I could completely understand what these guys are thinking, with the exception of why they care to stop Lucemane if she's just gonna destroy Necrozma and save them. If that's what she's doing, I don't understand why that's a problem. But if there's something more to it that I missed, or there's more they're gonna explain later as to why that's a problem, then I will totally understand. Necrozma, will you battle it? Can I say no? Can I say no? Can I say no? Can I say no, please? They're answering for me. They're answering for me. Guys, you guys are gonna battle her. You guys are not gonna battle Necrozma, but don't. Well, I don't have to fight Hapu? I don't have to fight Hapu. Am I healed? I'm not healed. I don't feel right about this. Can you heal me, Hapu? You battle it. I probably have no choice. Can you heal me, Lily? So I don't have to fly back and fly back here again? I don't fight Hapu. Why don't I fight Hapu? Does that mean she's gonna have a surprise fight later? Like at the end of Vasponi Canyon? Or like right before the Pokemon League? Or maybe she's part of the Elite Four this time? I don't know. Thank you very much, Liz, for healing. I really appreciate that. Okay, but I'm very surprised to not fight Hapu. I'm gonna assume we're gonna fight her later, and it'll be like a surprise battle. Surprise! Here's Hapu! Like, riding full force toward us on her Mudsdale. Look out, here I come! And we get trampled, and we die. Wild charge. Maybe it'll be useful. Doubt it, though. I'm not a fan of recoil moves. But you never know. Alright, Vast Pony Canyon. Let's catch something here after we kill this trainer. Turns we should be free! Freedom is good! Freedom! And he does not have a Braviary. Unless they change what his Pokemon had between the two games, Behem. No. But Behem is an interesting Pokemon. I don't think it's very good, but it's an interesting Pokemon that I feel like they should have made better. Because, like, it's kind of useless. It's just it's a random Psychic type with, like, it can't really do anything unique that other Psychic types can't do, which is a shame. I wish it did have something unique about it. And Banette, no. But look, we got Sabina. Although, maybe I shouldn't have stayed in, because... Yeah. At least it used a two-turn move. Saber, you resist Ghost. You're the only one who resists Ghost, actually. I'm wondering if I should prepare for Hapu's battle. But then again, I don't know when she's going to fight us. I don't want to just... I don't know. I don't know how I can prepare for the fight if I don't know when it's going to be. Oh, come on! I should have sucker punched. I didn't think it would do the same thing. I thought, like, Will-O-Wispers. That felt completely unwarranted and unfair. Don't know about the rest of you. What you girls do you think? Fine, maybe I should use Sucker Punch first turn, but I hate Sucker Punch. And now I gotta resist another Phantom Force, just because. Just because what I have to do. I literally have no other choice. I just have to resist, I just have to take the attack. My god, what a joke. Well, I guess we'll catch a Pokemon here, and then we'll be done here, so I can then decide who we're replacing Saber with. That is so dumb! Alright, it's a critical hit, what can you do? Yeah, sure, should use Sucker Punch first turn. I also didn't realize Banette would be faster than me. I thought Banette was fairly slow. Not, like, extremely slow, but I thought Banette was slow enough to be slower than Absol. But I guess I don't know. You know, I thought the same thing about how my Crobat, Claymore, should have been faster than, Plumeria Salazzle, and it wasn't, even though Crobat does have higher base speed. Or, by all logic, it should have been faster, but it wasn't for some reason. So, what can you do? What do we got in this cave? Golbat. Speaking of my Crobat, Claymore, we can't catch that. I'll let you know when I find something I can catch. Oh, hey, Carbink. I guess it's frickin' Carbink. Yeah, I had Felch and a friend to run away from things easier because, yeah. Other people weren't good at running away from things. Let's go to Machete, I guess? Yeah, we'll use, like, Shadow Claw or something. Or maybe I should've just used a Quick Ball. That probably would've been better. Oh, well. Did I run out? I may have run out, to be honest. I don't actually remember. Whatever, let's Shadow Claw it. Yeah, I'm really not a big fan of Carbink, to be quite honest, but who knows? It might come in handy. And it switched our skills. So, it gave me Clear Body, and it took Steel Worker. Okay. Shadow Claw one more time, we'll be good. Quick Claw didn't matter, but fine. Thank you for the Quick Claw boost. Slice! Skills up again. Oh, we're gonna switch back? Oh, you were unhappy with that decision? Oh, I'm sorry about that. It's okay, we'll switch back. I appreciate you willing to trade back so quickly. Wait just a frickin' minute. Guys? I wanna try something. I just thought of something. I wanna try something. Where, Adrenaline Orb. I want to try something. I've said I am allowed to catch Pokemon that come in SOS battles. I said I was, okay? Just want to make that clear. I said I was allowed to catch Pokemon that are... There you are! Oh my god! Oh my god, it worked. Get out of here, Carbink. I'm getting the Sableye. I'm getting a Sableye! That's who's replacing Saber! Sableye! It probably doesn't have Prankster, though, which is really unfortunate that it doesn't have, it probably doesn't. Would Shadow Claw, do you think it'll do too much damage? Sableye is not super defensive. You know what? I'm gonna just throw a ball. I'm kind of afraid of killing it. I really, really want this thing. Let's throw a Dusk Ball. If that doesn't work, I'll switch out to someone else and do some attacks that I'm fairly certain are weaker. Like, Flame Charge with Falchion or something, maybe? Shadow Ball? Oh, yeah, I forgot that I'm weak to it. Ow. Ow, ow, ow. All right, yeah, let's go to Falchion. We'll use a couple Flame Charges. I don't think that's not too strong of a move. It's only 50 base power. I use Quick Attack, but that won't even hurt me. Zen Headbutt, neat. I don't know why, guys, but oh, I burned it. Oh, no, I don't want to burn it. I have a time limit now. I don't want that. Whatever, Flame Charge, and then we're gonna throw balls. I don't care how much this does, unless, you know, it kills it. That's done, we're done. Okay, throw balls. Foul play, oh. Ow, that was a critical hit. Okay, then we're fine. Throw more balls! Dusk Ball! Because we're in a cave. We gotta use Dusk Balls in a cave. I still wish they should make a day ball. You know, Dusk Balls for nighttime and in caves? They should make a daytime ball for daytime and outside, you know? Ow. We gotta switch out now, which sucks because it'll get another turn of possibly dying. Let's go to Spadroon. I like that it's not calling for help. Did I just jinx it by saying that? Zen Headbutt. Hope I didn't jinx it by saying that, because I wanted to call for more help, because then if it calls on the same line, then who cares? Because that's fine. You know, it's been a while. Let's try, not a repeat ball, Timer Ball. It's in the turn, it's been a lot of turns. Timer Ball. Sableye! Yeah! I have no idea why, guys, but I've wanted to use a Sableye and a Nuzlocke for a very long time. I don't know why. They're probably not even that good. Like, he's probably not even gonna be that great, but I don't care. I want him. I want to try Sableye out. That was a genius idea, if I do say so myself, because I'm totally allowed. I said I'm totally allowed to catch Pokemon that are called during an SOS battle. Nickname for Sableye. Let's do this. This is Kukri. Kind of sounds like Kukui, who's a character in this game, I guess. Let's look at Kukri's summary. And we have Keen Eye. A wide lens, though. I don't think I'm going to use that, to be honest. But hey, careful nature, so minus special attack. I think that's all right, because I think it's a physical attacker anyway. So, yeah, I don't think it's going to be that great, but I'm going to use it anyway. And, you know, foul play might not actually be a bad idea to have for, like, because, you know, you use the enemy's attack power. So, you know what? Kruki, I'm going to add you to my party immediately. And you're going to be who I train up in replacement and do replace Saber. I decided it. Has a muscle band placed in your bag. Then again. There's a fairy trial coming up. I don't know when that is. I don't know when that is. Although maybe it's during Vast Money Canyon. Maybe it's where you meet Mina originally in the first Sun and Moon, but she actually has a trial there this time. Maybe I shouldn't use Kukri yet. Because Kukri's only weakness is fairy. Is there an item that can swap abilities? I swear there's an item in this game that lets you, that, like, you can change your Pokemon's ability. Like an ability capsule? Is that a thing? But I don't know if it could change to a hidden ability. That's the thing. Like, I believe Sableye has two normal abilities. I believe they're Keen Eye and Pressure, maybe? So, I don't know. And I'm pretty sure ability caps is only available from, like, Battle Tree and stuff like that. So, chances are I'm not going to use him. But, eh. I really just want to use a Mega Sableye, to be quite honest. And with... I honestly wanted to have Prankster. That's what I really wanted. I wanted to have Sableye with Prankster and a Nuzlocke. I don't think it's going to happen, to be honest. But it was worth a try. I don't think it's going to be Kukri because he's not going to be good for fairies, which is what we're going to be up against next. Who would be good against fairies? So the only thing I have that's really good against fairies is Foil the Magnemite and Nimcha the Ariados. And I'm not really looking... I don't really want to use either of them, to be honest. Foil I'd actually be okay with, but... What if Hapu comes in and is all like, surprise battle with me? And yeah, Foil will be useless against her. So... I'm going to fight fairy with fairy. We are going with Glaive. I will have Glaive changed up in the next episode. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. I hope to see you all in the next episode where we'll have Glaive chained up. And we will continue to Vastponi Canyon. See what the heck is awaiting us there. So yeah, as always, hope you enjoyed. And I will see you next time. Rock on.